Hi, I'm Tom Corbett, one of the photoelectric product managers at Pepperell & Fuchs. Diffuse photoelectric sensors are one of the most basic and cost-effective photoelectric sensors available. Light is emitted from the sensor, reflected off the target to be sensed, and received back to the sensor. They're preferred over retroreflective and through-beam sensors because there's no reflector or separate receiver that needs to be installed or mounted, which saves time and money. But a diffuse sensor's output switches states or turns on based on the amount of light that's reflected and returned from the target. So there's a certain threshold or amount of light that the sensor needs to have returned in order for the output to switch states. And since white or highly reflective objects will return much more light as compared to dark or dull targets, they're detected at much different ranges. If you've ever had to readjust a diffuse sensor because the color of the target changed, the next demonstration is for you. What I'm going to demonstrate is how a diffuse sensor detects black and white targets at very different ranges. First, I'll adjust the range of a standard diffuse sensor so that it sees a white target at 220 millimeters. I'll do this by turning the potentiometer counterclockwise so the output just turns off. Then I'll slowly turn the potentiometer clockwise until the output just turns back on. When I slide the white target out of range and back to the 220 millimeter mark, the output turns off and then on again. Note that it doesn't turn on at exactly 220 millimeters, but somewhere a little greater than the 220 millimeter mark. Now I'll rotate the block so that the black target is facing the sensor. The diffuse sensor doesn't detect the black target at 220 millimeters. In fact, I have to move the target all the way to about 70 millimeters before the diffuse sensor detects it, a significant reduction in range compared to the white target. And watch what happens when I place a shiny object in the background beyond the 220 millimeter mark. The shiny piece of metal is detected much further than the 220 millimeter distance I set the white target at. So as I just demonstrated, a diffuse sensor is very color dependent when it comes to detecting different color targets. A white target or a highly reflective target will reflect more light than a dark target at the same range. And a shiny target will significantly increase the range, something you'll have to be aware of if shiny surfaces could be in the background. And it's not just this particular diffuse sensor, it's all diffuse sensors. That's because the output turning on is based on the amount of light. If it's above a certain threshold, then the output switches states. Wouldn't it be great if black and white targets were detected at equal distances? If you only had to adjust the sensor initially, and then you didn't have to readjust the sensor every time the target color changed. Well, this is true for background suppression sensors. Background suppression sensors are a special version of a diffuse sensor. Instead of having just one receiver element inside, background suppression sensors contain two or more receivers. In the case of the R100 background suppression sensor shown here, the receiver is actually a multi-pixel array, or an array of receiver elements. Unlike a standard diffuse sensor, background suppression sensors detect targets not based on the amount of light, but which receiver or which receiver elements light is triangulated back on. Because of this, background suppression sensors are sometimes called triangulation sensors. And unlike diffuse sensors, background suppression sensors have a sharp cutoff, allowing them to detect targets in the foreground and then suppress objects beyond a set distance. So now let's do the demonstration again, this time with the R100 background suppression sensor in place of the diffuse sensor. Like I did with the diffuse sensor, I'll adjust the R100 so that it just sees a white target at 220 millimeters. I'll turn the potentiometer counterclockwise so the output just turns off, then I'll slowly turn the potentiometer clockwise until the output just turns back on again. As I slide the white target out of range and back into range, notice how the R100's output turns on at precisely 200 millimeters, unlike the diffuse sensor, which turned on around the 220 millimeter range. Now I'll rotate the block so that the black target is facing the sensor. But watch how even when I move the black target out of range and back into range, the R100's output turns on at 220 millimeters, just like it did with the white target. And then I place the same shiny target in front of the sensor. It too is detected at 220 millimeters, but no further. As you can see, detecting black and white targets at the same distance can be done. You just need to choose the right sensor. Thank you for watching this video on the R100 background suppression sensor.